Hello and welcome to the Soulblight Gravelords painting video. In this video, we're going to show how to paint the Deathrattle Skeletons, black robes and ancient steel armour that's featured on the front of the box. Now before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. Now, as you can see here, I've used Mechanica Standard Grey, which is a nice starting point for this colour scheme. Now our first colour is going to be Black Templar. I'm going to apply this all over the robes. So what I'm going to do is just grab myself a medium layer brush and just apply some of that onto the palette. Now I'm not thinning it down, I'm just using the palette so I can get a nice point to the brush. Then all we're going to then do is then start coating that on the robes. Now the great thing about using Black Templar over Mechanica Standard Grey, as it dries, it'll pull away from the edges a bit, which will give you your first little highlight. There we are, the Black Templar now applied and dry. What we're now going to do is move on to highlighting. Now our first colour is going to be Thunderhawk Blue. We're just going to move that all around the edges and on the folds of the cloth. And after that, we're going to finish off with our final highlight of Fenrisian Grey. But first of all, let's start with Thunderhawk Blue. So all I'm going to do is just get my small layer brush now, apply it over to the palette and add a little bit of water as well because I don't want it too thick. And then get a nice point. So to get a good point, just spin your brush around a couple of times like so, and then you're ready. And some places when you're doing the folds of the cloth, it's really easy just to use the edge of your brush and work your way around like so. But in some places you're going to have to use the tip of your brush. And when doing that, you're just going to have to hold your breath a little, just steady your arms and take your time. There we are with the Thunderhawk Blue now applied. What we're now going to do is use Fenrisian Grey and just pick out some of the higher points of those folds and the edge highlights. And if you do find there's any mistakes been made, just get some Black Templar and then just tidy back up in the recesses with that. There we are, now that we've done the black cloth, what we're now going to do is move on to the ancient steel armour. So we're going to start first by base coating with Iron Warriors. Once that's done, we're then going to use Basilicane and Grey and drop that all over just to darken it down a little bit more. Then we're going to start our first highlighter with Iron Hand Steel. This is also going to do some scratches on the armour as well. Then to make it feel a little bit more aged and rusty, we're going to get some Agrax Earthshade and drop that in the recesses and then finish off with a highlight of Stormhost Silver. And we'll also do some scratches with that as well. But first of all, let's start with Iron Warriors. So what I'm going to do is just grab a little bit, as we always do with our base coats, onto the palette, add a little bit of water. And then of course, get a nice point to our brush. Now I'm using a medium layer brush here because it's quite a lot of metal to coat. I'm just going to take my time. In some of the smaller areas, like his little tassets here, you might want to move to a smaller layer brush. Just those large areas, take your time. And if you do make any mistakes and get it on the black, just tidy back up with those previous colours. There we are, the Iron Warriors now base coated. What we're now going to do is coat over all the Iron Warriors using Basilicon and Grey. Take your time. Just make sure if you do get it on other areas to tidy back up. There we are, with the Basilicon and Grey now dry. What we're now going to do is use some Iron Hand Steel and start highlighting up this armour. So first of all, I'm just going to start picking out the edges like so, like down the little breastplate here. And also, I'm going to do some little scratches as well, just make it look a bit older. Take your time. Don't overthink the scratches, just do little ones here and there. Now that we've done that first highlight, what we're now going to do is just tone it back a little bit and also in the deeper recesses by using some Agrax Earthshade. So on the breastplate, I'm going about halfway up, just to make it feel a bit old and worn. And some of those little scratches, just going to drop a little bit of Agrax Earthshade there as well. Again, around rivets and things like that. Again, you can drop it into the recesses, but also in little places here so it looks a bit corroded. There we are, the Agrax Earthshade now dry. We're now going to finish off with a few highlights of Stormhost Silver. So I'm not going to go too mad. Just going to pick out things like rivets and stuff. And also do like a couple of little extra scratches here and there, as if they're like fresh ones. And there we are, our black robes and ancient steel armour are now completed. And remember, by following this guide, you can easily transfer this to other Soulblight Gravelord units in your collections. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own robes and armour. And we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.